from all around your lawn. I'm here to tell you how football is strong.
And welcome back. And of course, every Saturday morning, we look forward to this segment. We talk about everything that's under 18s. Here's Dale.
Thanks again, Dick. Yeah, some interesting rounds last weekend. Unfortunately, the result from the Invalide Cryer game wasn't in their paper, but I'm assuming Invalide won because they still hold their second spot. So Bannockburn played the Belmont Lions out there. Bannockburn 24-12, 156, defeated Belmont 7-5-47. Robinson had got 5 for Bannockburn, Kenyon 4, Pasala and Arklay 3. Better players there, Cross, Maguire, Arklay and Kenyon. And for the Belmont Lions, Previty got 4, Pike, Lovett and Vermeulen all with 1. Better players there, Cleal, Patterson, Lovett and Thorpe. North Geelong, the Magpies, one good sign for you, Dick. They're on top still and we hard to move. 18-16, 124, defeated Werribee, 4-6-30. Joes with 6, Smith and Eels with 3, Hope 2. Better players there, Phillips, Eels, Joes and Gasper. For the Werribee side, Hicks, Casia, Blade and Camilleri all with 1. And better players, Kales, Foster, Blade and Harkness. Thompson Tigers, they had a win on the weekend. They played Cryer, so it couldn't have been Invalide Cryer on the weekend. It must have been someone else.
No.
Must have been Winchelsea then. 13-10-88, Thompson defeated Cryer 7-4-46. Gardner, 4.
Timmy.
Hyder, 3. Brown and Pavlovic, 2. And better players there, Hyder, Gardner, Darra and Campbell, Jude. And the Cryer side, Tabor and Taylor with 2. Smith and O'Kane, 1 apiece. And better players there, Hum, Shelley, Angock, and McCready. So that now leaves us, Dick, to this week's draw, which is round 17. Invalide take on Cryer, so I was a week ahead of myself. East Geelong take on Winchelsea. Werribee Central's on take on Thompson. The Belmont Lions at home to North Geelong. Bannockburn the bye. And the Belmont Lions player, Sean Jubber, plays his 150th game for the club this afternoon. The ladder, as you can see on the television there, is North Geelong on top on 60. Invalide and Bannockburn both on 52. Werribee on 48. Beaumont Lions on 36, Thompson on 32, Cario on 12, East Geelong 12, and the Winchelsea side on 8 points.
Fantastic. Thanks very much, Dale. Of course, Dale will be back again next Saturday morning talking about everything under 18 as we're close to the finals action. It'll be very exciting indeed. As I said in the first segment, we've got a very special guest on the show this morning, and the floor manager is absolutely beside himself. He's even in uniform today. I've never seen that before. We have with us this morning, he is the coach of the rampaging Belmont Lions, who are doing absolutely nothing wrong at the moment, getting better and better every week. And as I said, they wish they had another 10 rounds. They'd have a fair crack at making the finals. Don't you worry about the way they're playing at the moment. He's come from Mitcham. I don't know what they call, we'll find out in a minute, but the Mitcham Footy Club. He's had a bit of form, I can tell you. He's been around a bit. And he's the new coach of the Belmont Lions for 2011. He's also the man from the Torquay Tats Lotto down there in the beautiful beachside town of Torquay. Paul Nigro. Good morning, Paul.
Good morning, Dick, and thanks for those kind words.
That's lovely, mate. Welcome. And before you go on, mate, quickly, being Saturday morning, of course, can you give us the Powerball numbers for last Thursday night?
I'd have to look after myself as well, Dick.
Just, you can just sort of give us those. I mean, everyone would know what they are now, Saturday morning.
Yeah, no, good.
Give us a fair crack out. We win.
I'd love to know beforehand, but that's not the case, and... I'd love to sell a winning ticket to someone in Torquay or the vicinity thereof.
Yeah, that's last Thursday night I'm talking about, next Thursday night.
Or, or Saturday after the game.
Good on you, mate. No worries. Now, tell us, Paul, you came down to Belmont. Obviously, you came down to Torquay to live, I guess, with jobs.
Yes.
And then how did you get involved with the Belmont Lions?
Yeah, we moved, the family moved down to Torquay and bought the business.
Yep.
I was the current coach of Mitcham Football Club in the Eastern Football League prior to our move, resigned there. Had a year off due to the business move, relocation, etc., family relocation, and decided to, towards the end of that year to get straight back into it because I missed it terribly. Mm. Spoke to two or three clubs at the end of last year, and Belmont were extremely proactive. It obviously had a couple of tough years. Mm. They made no secret of that fact of where they were at, and Mitcham drew a fairly good analogy of where they were at when I took them over. Mm. They were... in a probably a slightly worse position at the time, and I like a challenge. I like to lead a group of men on a common journey and to a destination, and to see them improve. And certainly we improved at Mitcham. We staved off relegation for the first year, and hence today they're playing hopefully finals this year, if not very close to. So that's over a progress of 3 or 4 years. Belmont, the president and vice president were very proactive, and what I saw I liked. It was going to be a challenge from where they were at. They made no mistake, and obviously reflecting on their scores from the previous year, things didn't look terribly flash on paper. But we sat down, spoke about what I could offer the club, obviously a non-playing coach. It's fair to say they were looking for a strong leader, as someone who did have a fair degree of coaching experience, and I fitted their bill. And as time's worn on, the club's fitted me very well as well.
It's been an up and down season in a lot of ways, but the last 5 weeks, which we're talking about all the time at the moment, the Lions are absolutely on fire at the moment. Are you pretty excited about that? And I guess you do wish that the season may go a few more weeks extra, but it is a great platform for 2012, isn't it?
Yeah, it's common saying in football, the F word was never on the radar at Belmont this
year. Sorry, what was it?
Yeah, the F word being the finals word.
Yeah, I'll go back to the donuts and cups of tea then. I don't know where we're going then. It's
a common phrase, but it was never on the radar.
Yep.
And now, for outsiders looking in, our first half of the year, the win-loss ratio, not great, sitting at 111, but 110, but we knew internally we were still tracking okay. Our performances, whilst we didn't find the line, in most cases, perhaps barring one or two, were more than creditable, and I was satisfied with where we were heading.
Mm.
And so was the club internally. We recognised the turning point of the season after we'd played everyone. Obviously, the Corio game, we sat down as a group, realised that was a game where we had some winnable games in the second half of the season. We drew that line. I felt we were a lot better prepared. Obviously, I'd had a good look at the 11 sides for the first time as well. Mm. And the group had become a lot stronger. Again, all those key words, our game plan, processes, structures, take time. And they're not perfect yet, but we're tracking in the right direction. We drew that line. And yes, we've had a very good 4 or 5 weeks of football.
Paul, you've obviously with a new group, and that's probably the big thing, I think, with Belmont Lions. They've had a big changeover of playing group come the last 2 or 3 years. And obviously that was the basic process, I suppose, getting that group of players to play the way you want them to. Yep. Obviously the benefits are there now. Now, there's some talk about some blokes coming back again next year, so obviously don't want to look too far ahead, but that would also give you a little bit of hope in obviously the Belmont Lions in their movement going forward into playing maybe some final football again.
Yeah, look, we've laid a base. We've laid a good foundation. And we're going to do it the right way. I sat down with the committee, and we want the right people at the club for the right reasons. And there won't be any detraction from that. And we will sit down as a group. We're already sat down, but targeted what we need or what I think we need to take that next step. And yes, finals could be a possibility. I'm not going to sit here and say that's the main goal at the moment. Obviously, it's a rotational draw in this league, which is new to me from where I've come from in terms of you don't play everyone twice. Mm. So we need to sit down and analyse that as well and see what we need to go forward.
Paul, thanks very much for coming in this morning. I know it's pretty tough on a Saturday morning. You've got to get the old Tats Lotto open.
And then straight to footy.
You can't remember what those Powerball numbers were from last Thursday night.
They still elude me.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, I just want to know we might have got across the line there. But thanks for coming in, mate. All the best for the Belmont Lions, not only for the rest of the season, but obviously for next year as well. And I hope you do take the helm next year, because we love to see the Belmont Lions play good footy, and like to see our floor manager, Happy Cogsy, and he does more around the club than changing those light clubs in the scoreboard. So thanks very much, mate, and all the best to the Belmont Lions.
No problem, thank you, and I can reassure you I will be coaching Belmont next year.
Good on you, mate, that's fantastic.
Right,
good news for the Belmont Lions supporters. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we're going to talk about all the action on this afternoon. Back after this.